Hello everyone. So through this video, I am going to start the third chapter of class 6th, that is word processor tabular presentation. So in this video, I will discuss about one of the feature of MS Word, that is table. Okay, so now let us start. So the first question that arises in our mind is what is table and what is the use of table? Okay. So table is the combination of rows and columns which is used to present data or information in an organized manner. Okay, and what is data? So data can be any text, numbers, pictures and other objects like shapes, etc. Okay, so now what is table? Table is an organized arrangement of data which consists of number of rows and columns, and table is used to present information in an organized manner. Okay, one of the important term which is used in a table is cell. Okay, so what is cell? Cell is the intersection of a column and row. Okay, so that is table. The next topic is creating a table. So MS Word provides us a variety of ways by which we can create a table. Okay, so we can see on the screen. So these are the different ways by which we can create a table. Okay, so we will understand each way practically. So the first one is using table grid. Okay, so whenever we want to insert any table in MS Word, so we have to perform some steps. Okay, so the first step is click the insert tab. Okay, so whenever we click the insert tab, we will see so many groups will be appear on the screen, like pages group, tables group, add-ins, media, etc. Okay, so one group is here, that is tables group, and this tables group is containing the table button. Okay, so whenever we click the table button, we will get a drop down menu which contains the options or the ways by which we can insert the table. Okay, so first of all, we are going to understand using the table grid. Okay, simply drag the mouse pointer over the grid to select the number of rows and columns from here. Okay, so I have simply just dragging the mouse pointer over this grid, and I am selecting simply the column and rows from here. Okay, so whenever we click inside this grid, then we will see one table will be appear on the working area of MS Word. So this is the table which is inserted using the grid option of inserting a table. Okay, so here we can see this is the table. Okay, so this is the cell. Okay, the cell is, we all know that cell is the intersection of row and column. Okay, so these are the cells which are present inside this table. The second way is using insert table dialog box. Okay, so we will understand this way by the help of practical. Here we are again in the working area of MS Word. We have to perform the same steps again. Again, we have to click the insert tab, then table button. Then we will see the drop down menu will be appear of this table button, and here we can see one option is there, that is insert table. Okay, so click the insert table option from here, and then we will get a insert table dialog box on the screen. Okay, so here we can observe some option are appearing here. The option is number of columns and number of rows. Okay, so here we have to type the number of columns and number of rows, and according to that numbers we will get a new table on the screen, or we can say the new table will be inserted in the working area of MS Word. Okay, so simply I am typing here 4 columns and 4 rows. Okay, and click the OK button. So now we can see one more table will be inserted, one more table has inserted here, and this table is containing four columns and four rows. Okay. The third way is draw table. Okay. So now just understand this method by using the practical. So here we have to perform the same steps again. Click the insert tab, then table button, drop down menu of table button will be appear here. And this time we will choose the another option, that is draw table option. Okay, simply click it. So whenever we click the draw table option, then our mouse pointer will be changed into a pencil icon. Okay, so we can see that pencil icon on the screen. Okay, and simply draw the table according to your need. Okay, like this. Then we have to add the columns here like this. Okay, simply drag the mouse and draw the lines of columns here, then rows like this. Okay, like this. So this is the table which has created by the help of draw table, a way of a table button of tables groups. Okay, the last way of creating a table is quick tables. Okay, so what is quick tables? So quick tables are a quick and easy way to insert a pre-designed tables in your document. Okay, and these tables are the most commonly used table layouts saved in quick tables gallery as building blocks. Okay, so now understand it practically. So here we are again in the working area of MS Word. Again we have to click the insert tab, then tables button, then drop down menu will be appear, and here we can see table quick tables option is appearing here. So whenever we click the quick tables option, then we will observe the predefined tables are appearing here. Okay, so just select any one from here which you want to use in your document. So I am just selecting this one. Okay, so now just observe here. So this is the table which is the output of quick tables, or we can say that is the predefined table that is already stored in MS Word. Okay, so this is the way of quick tables by which we can add a table that is already stored in MS Word. Okay, the next topic is converting text to table. Okay, so in MS Word we can also convert any existing text into a table. Okay, so now just understand it practically. Suppose that we have some data like this and we want to convert this text, or we can say we want to arrange this text into a table form. Okay, so the steps are, first step is simply select the text which we want to convert into a tabular form. Okay, and then click the insert tab, then table button, and here we will see one option is appearing here that is called convert text to table. Okay, simply click it, a dialog box will be appear here, that is the convert text to table dialog box. Okay, and automatically the number of rows and number of columns according to this text will be appear here. Okay, and simply click the OK button, then we will observe automatically that text will be arranged in a tabular form. Okay, so this is the way by which we can convert any text into a tabular format. The next topic is entering data. So now we are going to understand how can we enter data into a table, as well as which keys are used to move within the table. Okay, so just understand it practically. So this is the table which I have entered here, and this is the working area of MS Word screen. Okay, so whenever we want to enter any data into a table, simply click the cell where you want to add the data. Okay, and type the information like this. Okay, so whenever we want to move within the table, so we can use arrow keys up, down, as well as a tab keys. Okay, so for moving from means one cell to add to the next cell, to the adjoining cell, we can use tab key, as well as we can use left and right arrow. Okay, whenever we want to move downward side or downward cell, we can use down arrow. Okay, and whenever we want to move upside, we can use up arrow. Okay, as well as if we want to move to the previous cell, so we can use shift plus tab shortcut key. Just observe that. Okay, so these are the keys which we can use for moving within the table. Okay, now the next information I am typing here, that is English. Next one is Hindi. Next one is math. Okay, so this is the way by which we can add or we can enter data into a table. The next topic is selecting a cell, column and table using mouse. Okay, so just understand it practically again. So this is the table, and here I am going to perform some actions like selecting any cell, selecting the row, selecting the columns and selecting the entire table. Okay, using only the mouse. Okay, so whenever we want to select any single cell, so simply just move the mouse pointer at the corner, or we can say at the left edge of the cell. Okay, so whenever we move the mouse at the left edge of the cell which we want to select, the mouse pointer will be changed into a black arrow. Okay, and simply click the mouse button, and then we will observe the single cell will be selected. Okay, again, if you want to select this cell, okay, simply just move the mouse pointer at the left edge of the cell. Okay, and again the mouse pointer will be changed into a black arrow, and simply click it, and then the cell will be selected. Okay, the next action is if we want to select a row, again simply click simply just move the mouse pointer towards the left edge of the arrow which we want to select. Okay, suppose that I want to select this whole row. Okay, so just move the mouse pointer at the edge of this cell. Okay, means the first cell of that row, and click it, and then drag like this. Okay, then the whole row will be selected. Okay, the next one is if we want to select any column, so for that again the just move the mouse pointers at the top of that column. Okay, and whenever the mouse pointer into a change into this black arrow, simply just click and the whole column will be selected. Okay, and if we want to select the whole table, so for that we can observe here, this is the table handle, this is the table handle, and simply click this table handle, then we will observe the whole table will be selected. Okay, so this is the way by which we can select any cell, row, column and the whole table using the mouse. Next topic is selecting the text inside a single cell. Okay, so now just understand it again by the help of practical. Suppose this is a table, and here I'm just going to perform the selecting the text inside a single cell. Okay, so whenever we want to select any word, okay, so for that simply double click above the word. Suppose that I want to select Amit only. Okay, so just simply double click above the Amit, and the whole word means Amit will be selected. Okay, next one is if we want to select a sentence, so for that what can we do, simply hold down the control key and then click anywhere in the sentence. Okay, suppose this is the sentence, that is the good job. Okay, just hold down the control key and click anywhere above the good job, then we will observe the good job, or means we can take it as a whole sentence. So this will be selected. Okay, next one is if we want to select the whole, means the whole text here. Okay, means from good job to average work. Okay, so we can do that, simply just select using the mouse. Okay, the whole data will be selected. Okay, so this is the way by which we can select any text inside a cell or in a table. Okay. The next topic is editing a table. Okay, so after creating a table, we can make changes in the data as needed. That means we can insert rows, columns or cells according to our need into that table. Okay, so now just understand it practically. The first one is inserting columns and rows in a table. Okay, suppose that we want to add means some new columns and new rows according to our need in this table. Okay, so for that we have to perform some steps. Okay, the first step is if we want to add any column after this Hindi column. Okay, so first of all select the Hindi column. Okay, and then we have to click the layout tab. Okay, so whenever we click the layout tab, we will see rows and columns groups is here. Okay, and this rows and column group is containing so many buttons like insert above, insert below, insert left, insert right. Okay, so if we choose insert left, then we will see one empty column will be appears towards the left side of the selected column. Okay, and if we choose insert right button, then one empty column will be appears towards the right side of the selected column. Okay, next one is if we want to add new rows, so for that once again we have to perform some steps. Okay, first of all just select the row. Okay, means suppose that I want to add a new row after this Suman Suman row. Okay, so first of all just simply select the Suman row like this. Then the third row will be selected, and here again we have to choose the layout tab, and here we can observe insert above or insert below. These two buttons are appearing here. Okay, so if we choose insert above, so one empty row will be appeared above the third row. Okay, means above the selected row. As well as if we choose insert below button, then one empty row will be added after the selected row. Okay, so this is the way by which we can add new columns and rows in a table. In editing a table, next is deleting rows and columns. Okay, so now just again understand it by the help of practical. Suppose that I want to delete this column. Okay, so simply select this column and again click the layout tab. Okay, click the layout tab, and here in rows and columns group we can observe delete button is present. Okay, simply click the delete and select the option of delete columns from here. Then we will observe the selected column will be deleted. Okay, and suppose that we want to delete any row, so again select the row which we want to delete. Okay, like this, and this time again layout tab, rows and columns group, and delete button. Okay, this time we have to choose the delete rows option because we are going to delete the row. Okay, simply click the delete rows button and then the selected row will be deleted. Okay, so this is the way by which we can edit a table. Okay, so that's all for today. Later I will come with new topics of this chapter. Thanks to everyone.